Hello there. Good morning. Welcome to another beautiful Sunday. Welcome to the first Sunday in the month of October. Are you guys excited as I am? We've made it to the 10th month, guys. 10th month in the year 2020. Despite everything that has happened this year, you and I, we are here, and for that we are grateful to God. And as you know, in Celeb Kids, we are taking it a little deeper, a notch higher. And this month, our focus is going to be on God is good. God is good. But today's topic is God is good, with a focus on Noah and the flood. Just as you are right now, when I first heard this story, I was also in Sunday school. When I first heard about Noah and the flood, I was also in Sunday school, just as you are sitting right now. And I'm sure some of you might have resumed classes. You know, how has that been for you? If you have, if you haven't, how is it going for all of you? For me, it's very fine for me. I'm so excited. This is the month of October. Something special is happening to me the month of October. All right, people. My name is Wumi, and I have another tutor. His name is Sean. Together, Sean and I will be bringing God's words to you. We'll be teaching you about Noah and the flood, and it promises to be exciting. As usual, I want you to have three things available for me: your writing materials, which consists of your jotter and your pen, and your Bible. And finally, find a comfortable position, get prepared for service, and let's dig into it. Are you ready? All right, let's bow our heads in prayer. Heavenly Father, we say thank you for this wonderful day. We thank you for all that you add to us. We thank you for bringing us thus to the month of October. We thank you because, Lord, it's by your grace that we are here today. Thank you, Lord, for all that you have been doing in our families. And we say thank you, Lord, as we're about to go into your word, as we're about to fellowship with you, we ask that you open up our minds to understand. You grant us light into your words in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for in Jesus' mighty name I have prayed. Amen, amen, and amen. All right, guys, as usual, you know what's going on next. We're going to be dancing, we're going to be worshiping with some other kids on your screen coming soon, shortly. And I want you to actually participate. Dance if they're dancing, smile if they're smiling, jump if they're jumping. Just make sure that you have a good vibe with the kids on the screen and make sure that you dance. I will see you people just in about another 5 to 10 minutes again. Bye.
yo.
Welcome back from such a wonderful worship session. I hope you love it. I hope you enjoyed yourself. And we're about to dive into today's word. But just before we go, I want us to have a recap of what we did last month. We talked about so many things. Majorly, the themes were why hellfire was created, eternal life, who is heaven for, it's for us, and so much more. You know, we learned to also defend why, whenever people ask us, oh, if a loving God created, why did he create hell? And we thought on that, right? We thought on that last month. And also last week was our activity Sunday, and I really hope that you submitted your answers to the activity that we displayed last week. And if you haven't, you still have the opportunity to, and make sure that you submit it. We are looking out for it, right? So Sean is going to be taking the message very soon. It's coming in very soon. And I want to also tell you guys again, make sure that you are in a comfortable position without any form of distraction, because today is gonna be awesome. It's gonna be awesome. All right, kids, I'm gonna see you very soon. Bye.
Hi kids, welcome to today's session. I'm sure we're going to learn a lot of amazing things. We had a fantastic session with the worship and the praise session, right? So I'm going to go into today's class. But before we go further, I'm just going to share a little bit of background into what we're trying to teach for today, right? So, you know, when you're growing up, right, and probably you have something happen to your friend, and then probably you reach out to your parent, and then you ask them for solutions or suggestions, and they tell you that, oh, it's going to be all right, God is good, right? And God is good. But when you go further, you interact with other people outside your home, or probably on social media, or probably you get to meet new people. You hear a lot of stories, probably based on people's personal experience, where they say that God is not good. Some even go as far as citing examples from the Bible about God being not good, right? And then people begin to question why God has done this or why God has not done this. But today, we're here to come and share and come and give you more insight about these misinterpreted stories in the Bible, right? So that's what we're going to be doing throughout this month. So in particular, we're going to be talking about Noah and the ark and how the flood, you know, wiped away the whole earth. So we're going to be going into that today. But before we go further, we're going to take our memory verse. So I'm certain that you have your pen and you have your Bible and you have the notepad with you. So I'm going to start from Isaiah 54:9. So I'm going to read Isaiah 54:9. So Isaiah 54:9 says that this is like the time of Noah. I promised then that I would never flood the earth again. In the same way, I promise I will not be angry with you or punish you again. That's simply amazing. That God is saying, yeah, I promise I will not be angry with you again or punish you again. So if somebody promises not to do something again, you know that he or she will actually fulfill that promise, right? So I'm going to go further, and I would like you to do a bookmark on your Bible. So when I mean a bookmark, you can take like a pen or take some objects into your Bible onto Genesis chapter 6, because we'll be reading some verses from there. Yes. So I'm going to start from the first point, which talks about the fact that there was so much evil in the world at that particular time when Noah actually lived, right? Human beings were wicked to another, and there was so much corruption around, and God looked over and he wasn't happy, right? He created human beings and they had to do something different. The reason why he created us, you and me, was for fellowship, for love, you know, to cherish one another. But the human beings in Noah's time were doing something entirely different, and that was not his intention, right? He wanted everyone to live in peace and love one another. So imagine you're an inventor and invented a phone, and the phone is supposed to use to make calls, and then you find out that people are actually using that phones as rats. You won't be happy. That was how God was. It was very sad. But we're not just going to be talking about it. We're going to be looking at it in the Bible to actually see what happened. Right? That's why we're here. Right? So we're going to go to Genesis chapter 6, as we mentioned earlier. So we're going to read 5 to 6. So Genesis chapter 6, 5 to 6. So from 5, the Lord saw how great the wickedness of the human race had become on earth, and how every inclination of thought of the human heart was only evil all the time. 6. The Lord regretted he had made human beings on earth, and his heart was deeply troubled. So God wasn't happy, right, about what happened in the time of Noah. So we see it here, right? It's not like God just decided that he was going to wipe the whole earth without actually acknowledging what was happening. So he was seeing what was happening. Going further, the second thing I want you to actually to note about this entire story about Noah and the flood that wiped out the whole earth is that God had to intervene from all the wickedness that was in the world. That's why he had to destroy it. He did that for you and I, so that we will not be able to have a hard time living on earth. Can you imagine a world where everyone is corrupt, where no one respects law or order, and they can get away with doing bad things? That's going to be a terrible world to live in. So God was doing a good thing when he sent the flood. And before that, God actually searched, and he saw that it was only one man, Noah, and his family that were actually doing things that were right, while the rest of the world were doing wicked and evil things. But Noah did not. He continued to do the right thing, and God liked it, and made God very happy. He was loyal in his service to God, and his family honored God with him. That's simply faith, right? So thirdly, another thing I want to know, that God is a loving father. That's why we're sharing this story, and that's why I'm trying to make it more open for you. So God is a loving father. God provided an opportunity for the people to turn from their evil ways a lot of times. Many times it's painted like, oh, God just woke up one morning and then decided to flood the earth and kill everybody. But that's not true. God gave them opportunity. During the time when Noah was building the ark, Noah was also preaching to everyone, and he did that for a period of 60 years. But you know, guys, they were looking like Noah, like, oh, cool, because he's preaching, he doesn't want to know what he's saying. So they were laughed, they were relaxed, they only partied, and they disregarded the message that Noah had for him. So imagine, for 60 years, somebody was preaching to you, right, sharing the message to you about righteousness, and they didn't listen. They were actually so stubborn. Can you imagine? So if you are actually 10 years now, you'll have done your PhD, you'll have done your master's, in fact you had a 5 PhD within that period of time. So the people weren't listening to what was actually happening, right? And that's really not nice. So if you're 10 now, if you're at 60, you'll be 70 by the end of the day. So that was what was happening during that time, and that was the reason why God had to, you know, flood the earth. So we're going to go a little bit more deeper. So God actually promised never to destroy the world again after all the entire thing that happened, right? And that's another aspect to know how God is good, giving a promise that he's not going to do this again because he loves us and because he cherishes us, and he actually made an agreement. And we're going to see this in the Bible, that he made an agreement to actually continue to actually give us the opportunity live free and not to actually punish us with the flood again. So that's how loving it is. So we're going to read from Genesis 8:21 and Genesis 9:12-17. Now Genesis 8:21 and Genesis 9:12-17. So I'm going to start from Genesis 8:21. The Lord smelled the pleasing aroma and said in his heart, never again will I curse the ground because of humans, even though every inclination of the human heart is evil from childhood. I never again will I destroy all living creatures as I have done. And then we move to the next one, and that's Genesis 9:12-17. So Genesis 9:12-17, and God said, this is the sign of the covenant I am making between me and you, and every living creature, and every living creature with you, a covenant for all generations to come. I have set my rainbow in the clouds, and it will be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. Whenever I bring the clouds over the earth, and the rainbow appears in the clouds, I will remember my covenant between me and you, and all living creatures of every kind. Never again will the waters become a flood to destroy all life. Whenever the rainbow appears in the clouds, I will see it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and all living creatures of every kind on earth. 17. So God said to Noah, this is the sign of the covenant I have established between me and all life on earth. After the flood ended, God told Noah and his family to come out of the ark. The flood had actually drowned all living creatures on earth, and it remained only Noah, his wife, and their sons, and their sons' wife. There were the persons left on earth, and there were about 8 in number when he came out of the ark. So Noah worshipped God as he used to back there. He built an altar unto God, and made an offering unto God. God promised never to destroy the world again with flood. He put a rainbow in the sky as an agreement, so he won't be destroying the world again with the flood. So anytime you see a rainbow, it serves as a reminder of God keeping his promise to us. That's simply amazing. God signing an agreement to us. So I'm sure that today you've learned a lot of amazing things about Noah and the ark and how God is good, right? So we're going to do a lesson recap. That's a short summary of what we've learned today. So I know that today we've learned that the reason behind all of God's action is because he actually loves us, right? Because of his love for you and his love for myself, he cleansed the whole world of all the wickedness. Secondly, God does not desire that anyone should actually perish, right? He wants everyone to be saved. This is why Noah preached the people for several years. They didn't want to accept his message. They refused to accept his message, right? If you have a loving dad, if you do something wrong, your loving dad gives you an opportunity to come back to him and correct you. That's how loving God is. He gave them the opportunity for an entire 60 years, but the people were actually stubborn and they didn't listen. And God also promised never to destroy the world again by flood waters. So whenever you see a rainbow in the sky, remember that God is good. Finally, like Noah, we must continue to obey God and choose to do good despite everything. Even if people are doing evil around us, we must choose to be good. But before we go, I'd like us to recite our memory verse again, and that's Isaiah 54:9. So Isaiah 54:9, I'm going to read. The Lord says, this is like the time of Noah. I promised then I would never flood the world again. In the same way, I promise I will not be angry with you or punish you. Isaiah 54:9. So thank you for joining us today. We are going to be moving next to the activity for today, and we have some interesting answers and questions for you to have today. Thank you for joining. Welcome back to today's activity. Yes, so I'm going to be taking today's activities. I'm going to be answering some questions, and you can send your questions to alfiechildren@gmail.com that will be displayed on the screen. So you can answer questions. You can answer, actually, it's a crossword puzzle, right? You know how a crossword puzzle looks like. But if you don't have that, you can just simply answer those questions down. So we have about 7 questions. The first one says that, what did Noah do while he was building the ark? So you can answer what he actually did while he was building the ark, right? And then the second question says, how many years did Noah spend preaching to the people? That's the second question that we do have. And the third one says, what God doesn't desire for everyone? So we mentioned that earlier in our lesson. And then the fourth one also, what we should do despite every evil that is happening around us. We also mentioned that in today's lesson summary. And the sixth one is the rainbow sign, is the significance of what that particular rainbow sign has talked about. You know, what's the significance? And then the last one, the reason behind God's action. Why did God actually send the flood, right? So you can put in your answers and you can send it to happychildren@gmail.com. I've been looking forward to see your answers. In case you've not answered questions of last week, you can always send them. I'll be happy to answer your questions and be happy to reply you. So thank you for joining us for this activity. Umi will be joining us shortly and she'll be taking us through the closing prayer and the benediction. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you.
All right, children, we have come to the end of today's service. I want you to say thank you, Uncle Sheol, for bringing us such a wonderful word. I hope you learned it too, about God's loving nature and, you know, Noah and the flood, what really happened, right? This is a reminder to send your answers to your activities, questions displayed on the screen right now. Send this to outreachchildren@gmail.com and we'll be sure to get back to you. If you also have not done the one for last week, ensure you do it and you also send it. Ask your aunties, ask your uncles, ask your mom, ask your dad, your sisters, your brothers to help you if you need any technical assistance in this. All right, children. So now we're going to recite our benediction. By now, you should know it. I'm hoping that by now you know it. All right, let's go with me. We serve God by His Spirit. We boast in Christ Jesus. We put no confidence in the flesh. We experience progress and joy in the faith. Because we are Celebration Church. Celebration Church in Christ, for Christ, with joy. All right, people, I'm going to see you next week. Do have an awesome, awesome week, and reach out to us if you need anything. Make sure you wash your hands, make sure you practice social distancing, and also make sure you wear your face mask whenever you're going out. All right, children, I will see you same time next week. And for now, my name is Umi, and I'm telling you, bye.